really great song. Daniel's an amazing Aussie talent. But
he's
so good. Hey, I want to talk to you because my daughter Betty, she's 5 and a half, so she's right in the Mulan zone at the moment. And we heard some of that performance before, but how was your experience making that film?
It was actually the experience of recording the vocals. It came right on the heels of the 10th anniversary of Playmates at the Royal Albert Hall in London. So when you're on this really, really amazing high after that experience, and then a couple of weeks later you head to Los Angeles and you be a part of this, it's just an embarrassment of riches. And I can't believe my luck. It was amazing to just be in the same room as, say, the 75-80 orchestra getting to sing that music. And just to be in the, to paraphrase Hamilton, to be in the room where it happens, to see these amazing creative people just you know, put together something like this. And to see it so many years later, still finding itself so beloved. And now there's a live-action version that's going to come out very, very soon. So I'm excited for that.
Yeah, well, it's actually in next week when audiences will get a chance to watch that live-action remake. Do you think that they should have retold the story of Mulan? Or, I mean, can we really redo Perfection?
The original animated feature was based on a 1,000-year-old Chinese legend. So it's not like Mulan was coming from out of nowhere, passed down from generation to generation. There was a lot of source material. Yeah, so I guess technically you could say that the original Mulan was itself a remake of something, reimagining of something. And now this one is a reimagining of that reimagining. You know, so the great stories should always be told.
Yes.
And this is a great story that is going to, I am sure, touch the hearts of so many young women that see this young person standing up for her family and standing up for herself and trying to figure out who she is. And it's great to see an example of somebody who's beautiful and strong. And I mean, sword fights on rooftops? I mean, come on.
Bring it on. You have such a huge fan base around the world, including here in Australia. It was a great honor for me back in the late 90s to perform with you in the United Kingdom for Behaviors.
We were so young!
We were babies!
We were babies!
We were such babies! But, I mean, you were already like a superstar. I was in such awe of you. But with the pandemic shutting down productions and even TV productions across the globe, how are you coping and how are you dealing with it?
I'm actually dealing with it all pretty well. I'm a homebody anyway, so I'm perfectly content to stay at home, watch video games, do a little bit of yarn work, bake bread, just learning all of these different things. I figured, you know what, I'm not traveling, I'm not performing, I've got all the time in the world to learn how to do stuff. And I had to, as Daniel pointed out on Facebook, I had to learn how to do Logic X Pro while in quarantine to facilitate the recording of the sequence.
Of course, you had to learn how to be your own engineer.
Yeah, so I've become my own audio engineer, so if it's GarageBand, Logic Pro, I think I can figure stuff out on my own. The independence is quite nice.
Well, look, it's great to see you safe, and it's great to see you again. You have lots of fans here.